Hello everyone, my name is Eric, and I'm excited to tell you how to add accessibility to your Unity games. Accessibility is about allowing everyone to use our products. And today marks a huge leap forward for accessible gaming with Apple Accessibility plugin for Unity developers. We will focus on three Apple technologies for making your games accessible. VoiceOver is a screen reader which helps users who are blind or low vision. It reads items on the screen and provides custom gestures for users to interact with controls. Switch Control, which allows someone with low motor control to use an external switch for device interaction. And Dynamic Type, which allows people to set the text size according to their reading ability. To get started, clone the repository and build all of Apple's plugins using the build script in the root of the repository. This will produce a build folder that is ready for integration into your Unity projects. Finally, add the accessibility plugin to your own project using the Unity Package Manager. For more details, look at the documentations in the repository and watch the video about all of Apple's Unity plugins called Plugin and Play, add Apple frameworks to your Unity game projects. Now that you have the plugin, I'll guide you through three areas. First is accessibility elements. This allows you to add support to assistive technologies like VoiceOver or Switch Control for your games. Next is dynamic type. We create this easy-to-use utility that helps you scale text according to user preferences. And UI accommodations. These are utilities that helps you read other user preferences. Let's start with accessibility elements. I built a simple card game to help illustrate this concept. You might see that you should tap the flip button to draw two random cards. However, VoiceOver would not read the text on screen and an external switch would not tap the button, since these are just pixels on the screen right now. We need to help the system understand what can be interacted with. Accessibility elements define the things that assistive technologies can interact with. The text, cards, and the button on screen should be accessibility elements. And we can describe each element with a label. VoiceOver will read each label so the user can understand what's on the screen. And if the game supports multiple languages, we should localize these labels as well. Now VoiceOver can describe what's on the screen, but it doesn't recognize that there's a button that can be tapped. We can use another property called traits to inform the system of the element's type. We should add the button trait here. Now, VoiceOver will read flip button, and an external switch can control this button. We can also add static text trait on our text elements. The static text trait is usually given to labels and text areas so that VoiceOver can provide a better text interaction experience. And there are many more traits beyond button and static text that you can explore. So what trait should we use for the cards? Well, we don't need to use traits on every accessibility element. Our cards don't need any traits. However, there's still a part of each card that VoiceOver is not aware of, the face value. There's another property that we can use for this called value. Once we add a value for each card, VoiceOver will now read card 1 with value 3 of clubs, card 2 with value ace of clubs. And that's it. Now that you understand the basics, let's open Unity to see how to add them to our project. Here I am in a Unity editor for this game. I have already added the Apple Accessibility plugin to this project. First, we have the usual scene objects, like camera, direct light, and a UI canvas. Under the canvas, we have two text elements and a button. After that, we have two game objects for cards. Each is composed of two mesh components, each rendering a front and back texture for the card on each side. Let's start by defining our accessibility elements. To do this, we need the accessibility node component from this plugin. Select all game objects in the hierarchy that should be accessible, and add the accessibility node component to make them accessibility elements. Next, we add labels. Select the card object, go to accessibility node component on the right, and find the label field. And make sure the label field checkbox is checked to provide a custom label. Then type card 1. And the same for card 2. Text and buttons need labels too, but we don't have to provide an explicit accessibility labels for them if we are using the standard controls from Unity UI. The plugin already has default implementations for those. Next, we need to add a trait to our button. Select the flip button and change the traits from none to button. Select the two text elements and change traits to static text. Great! Lastly, we need to set an accessibility value for the card faces. Since the cards are randomly drawn, I need to add a script to set the value dynamically. Select the two cards and add a new script called AccessibleCard. First, in one of my other C# files, I already have an enum for all the card faces called playing card. In my new accessible card model behavior script, we have a variable for the card type and a boolean for whether the card is facing up or down. So now let's add the accessibility value to these cards. First, we get the accessibility node component attached to this game object. Next, set the accessibility value dedicate to a function that returns the card face value dynamically. Inside this function, if the card is covered, we return the covered for the accessibility value. Or if not covered, we will enumerate all card faces and return a description for each, like Ace of Spades. And that's it. Now, let's build our project and see it in action. Here's our game. Let's turn on VoiceOver.
VoiceOver on. Eric's game. Card 2. Covered.
I could swipe right to move to the next element.
Card 1. Covered. Eric's card game. Flip the cards. Flip button.
You see that all five objects are now accessible through VoiceOver, which is awesome. To tap the button when VoiceOver is on, do a double tap.
Flip.
Let's check the cards again.
Card 1, 2 of clubs. Card 2, ace of clubs.
VoiceOver now reads the updated card faces correctly. Cool! So we just made our game accessible to millions of VoiceOver users who can now fall in love with it. And people who use external Switch Control can also play our game. So that was accessibility elements. Next, let's talk about dynamic type. Games can be difficult to play for many people because text is too small to read. On iOS and tvOS, everyone can choose the right text size for their reading ability in settings. With the accessibility plugin, you can read the setting to make sure the text in your game is displayed at the expected size. Let's take a look at our game example to see how we can use dynamic type. Create a mono behavior script called dynamic text size.cs. In a start function, first store the default text size into a variable. Then inside the onEnable function, subscribe to setting change event using accessibility settings on preferred text sizes changed. This allows us to update the UI as soon as the user changes the text setting. Next, inside the settings changed function, first read the preferred content size multiplier, then multiply by your original text size, and assign it back to the text element. Inside Unity Editor, select all game objects that have a text element, and add the dynamic text size component that we just created. Now our game is all set for dynamic type support. Before we see the result in action, first, I'm going to show you a trick to quickly test dynamic type in your games. Open Settings and find Control Center. Scroll down until you see Text Size and add it to Control Center. Now, we can adjust text sizes quickly by opening Control Center and change the text size options. Great! As I change the text size, our game adjusts font sizes in real time. The text percentage value shown in Control Center is exactly what we're reading from that multiplier. You can also adopt this setting on non-text objects. For example, I can swap the card face assets to large print when size is increased. First, I create a script called dynamic card faces. Then, same thing as before, subscribe to the text size changed event. Instead of reading a multiplier, I read an enum of text size category that is mapped to the ticks on the Control Center slider. I could swap the asset whenever someone selects a larger text size. And I simply choose between a regular material and a large print material. Now, if we select a really large size, users will see a large print version of the cards, which are great card faces that are much easier to read for people with low vision. Lastly, I want to talk to you about UI accommodation settings that you can access with this plugin. The first setting is Reduce Transparency. When this setting is on, the background is turned opaque instead of a blur or transparent effect. It can help improve legibility when this effect makes text hard to read. To check this preference, call Accessibility Settings is Reduce Transparency enabled. Next, the Increase Contrast setting. Notice how the switches have a darker gray that helps them stand out. Making controls easier to recognize across the entire device. You can increase contrast for your own UI when this is enabled by checking this setting using Accessibility Settings, is Increase Contrast enabled. Next, the Reduce Motion setting. Some people are sensitive to motion like we have in this card flip animation. We should remove the animation when Reduce Motion is enabled. Let's look at the code to do this. In our card controller script, we have this flip function. First, we check if user's reduce motion setting is on. If not on, we should flip the card by invoking an animation through coroutine. Otherwise, we just set the rotation and no animations. And that's it. Now people who are sensitive to motion would enjoy our game. To recap, get started with the Apple Accessibility plugin by cloning the GitHub repository linked in this session's resources. Add accessibility elements so people can use VoiceOver and Switch Control with your games. Adapt your text size with dynamic type. And check for UI accommodations so everyone can have a great experience with your game. Thank you so much for joining me. We look forward to seeing how you make games available for everyone with a great accessibility experience.